16-year-old Bryce Nelson say he is the one who had to pay the price for his friend's bad decisions.
18-year-old Caleb Hoverston is charged with vehicular homicide in Nelson's death. Angie Hunt has more from the Ames Live Link.
Well, Stacey, Hoverston took off from a come-and-go early Saturday morning without paying for $52 in gas. He then ran from police, eventually crashing his car and killing Bryce Nelson and injuring two others. The circumstances leading up to this deadly crash do not make it any easier for John Nelson and Jean Haltom to deal with their grief.
We're furious.
The Nevada couple's only child, Bryce Nelson, was a passenger in this now mangled Firebird. He was friends with the driver, Caleb Hoverston, who ran a red light during a chase, crashing with an SUV at Lincoln Way in Duff.
What I was told was that when they crashed, it was 110. It's amazing anybody survived anything.
Ames police say the officer ended the pursuit several blocks before the crash.
We ran into more traffic at that point also, where the suspect vehicle was weaving in and out of other vehicles.
Nelson's parents struggle with the fact their son is dead while Hoverston walked away from the crash.
I'm glad Caleb's alive, and be it wrong of me, I'm sorry. I wish Caleb mental torment for a very long time.
Hoverston shouldn't have even been driving. His license is suspended. Court documents show the 18-year-old was also facing multiple theft and burglary charges. Nelson's parents say the two teens had recently become friends and don't want Hoverston's bad choices to reflect on their son.
Just because my child was in that car that killed him, he was not a bad kid. He did not get in trouble with the law.
Haltom said her son liked to act tough, but was a good kid.
There was nothing tough about him. He was a skinny little drink of water that just could brighten a room.
John and Jean say their son had asked to spend the night on Friday with Caleb Hoverston, and they say at first they were hesitant but did then say okay. Bryce Nelson was about to become a father. His parents say now he'll never have a chance to meet his son. Funeral arrangements have been set. Nelson's funeral will be Wednesday morning, 10:30 at Memorial Lutheran Church in Nevada.
Angie Hunt in the Ames Live Link tonight. Thank you, Angie. Two other people were injured in that crash. 38-year-old William Schroeder, who you see here from a previous story, is in critical condition. He was driving the car that collided with Hoverston. He's also the co-founder of Blue Sky Creamery. Another passenger in Hoverston's vehicle, 14-year-old Tori Page, also listed in critical condition.